bring it home, but I don't know.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, you may recall that at the meeting when the Board of Commissioners approved a conditional use permit with respect to the Bridgepoint Community Networks, one of the requests that the board made by way of a condition was for Bridgepoint to execute a restrictive covenant with respect to the property. That is what I have provided for you this evening. I would like the board to approve it just so the board is fully aware as what is in it and you can be comfortable with what it says. If you look at the minutes from the meeting, it basically says that the covenant will restrict certain off-site activities, although I think that was made within the context of certain active proselytizing activities. And so that's the way I have drafted this. This is a declaration of restrictions, covenants, and conditions that Bridgepoint has agreed to execute. So my plan would be for the Board of Commissioners to consider this, if you're comfortable with it, once I have read it to you, to approve it, and then I will get it to Bridgepoint so they can execute it and, quite frankly, file it in their title records. The moving parts of the Declaration of Restrictions, Covenants, and Conditions are paragraph one, and I want to read it to you, just so I can go right to it and you can have exactly in front of you what we're doing. The declarant, which is Bridgepoint, shall not utilize the subject property, which is their property, to organize or assemble for the conducting of, within the Crystal Cove Shores Subdivision, off-premise active proselytizing, parenthetical, meaning face-to-face solicitation or direct telephone solicitation, on behalf of any particular religion or denomination, provided, and by the way, I want to stop right there, that's the most significant component of the declaration. Provided this covenant will not prohibit the declarant from meeting with, marketing to, or inviting other persons within the Crystal Cove Shore Subdivision to lawful activities conducted at and upon the subject property. This covenant is not intended to prevent the declarant from conducting a faith-based ministry on the subject property, but rather to prevent the declarant from actively soliciting religious converts on the private property of Crystal Cove Shores Subdivision property owners without such property owners having first initiated or invited that communication or solicitation, it being the intent of this declaration that indiscriminate active proselytizing originating from the subject property shall not occur. I think you see a theme, and the theme is restated about three times within that covenant, and it's to prevent that piece of property from being the originator, from originating on that piece of property, that sort of proselytizing activity. Paragraph two is basically it's Bridgepoint agreeing that they are waiving any claim or cause of action that they might have against the government with respect to our putting this sort of prohibition in effect. And they are agreeable to executing this as well. So unless y'all have any questions for me, this is what the conditions require. This is what Bridgepoint has agreed to. And I just need a motion and second to approve the covenant so I can get it to Bridgepoint for execution.
All right, just one point of clarification.
Oh, well, yeah, Commissioner Amos, you just need to be quiet, and your recusal will continue from your
recusal. Does he need to make any sort of statement?
Well, just... I think the record should reflect that he was recused previously and he continues that recusal now.
Okay. Well, then I note that for the record that Commissioner Reyes is going to recuse himself from the action
taken
there.
I would, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we approve the declaration of restrictions, covenants, and conditions made and entered into as of the first day of September 2011 by Bridgepoint Community Networks.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, like sign. There are none. That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos having voluntarily recused himself.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Thank you. Okay. Item number 16, Commissioner Spock.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think in some discussion between Todd and myself, we would like to bring up a bit of conversation and hopefully ask staff to come back with some wording. In my particular idea is that, at least as a starting point for the conversation, I would like to make it something along the lines that no nonprofit organization can have a meeting hall or meeting room in anything other than probably commercial and office industrial zone property. That's a great point, except Ken, if a HOA, you know, some wording in there about unless established by a homeowners association. That's, you know, at least as far as I've been able to think it through, what will make me happen. And now, maybe there's some other category that's beyond CBD and office that makes sense that I have overlooked, but at least at this point, that's where I think it ought to be limited.
But explain again what you want to limit to those zoning ordinances.
Any meeting place for a nonprofit organization.
Well,
that's going to be tough.
Yeah, I mean, heck, there's a cattle association. They meet in people's homes and things like that.
No, 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 no. As an institutionalized place of meeting, it's always at this one place.
It's going to be a tough one still. You have to be real creative, I think.
I mean, if they continue to meet at one place, you're against that.
They could even do it privately. What I'm saying is we won't grant them a zoning or a cup or anything else that institutionalizes that meeting.
I think what he's trying to get at, it goes back to the Bridgepoint is. But I don't think it'll affect the Boy Scout type thing because you're not looking to get a cup.
He's nonprofit. He said nonprofit.
Yeah, he's going to have to word it a little bit.
But there is no, but there, I'm not aware of a Boy Scout place meeting hall that exists in a neighborhood.
What are churches?
I did the meetings in my house.
Churches are also nonprofit, and I think they should be limited to CBD and office industrial in the future.
I mean, but can't churches go on agriculture?
Now with a cup.
Conditionally.
Conditionally, yeah. So they, so that would change that. You'd have to change our UDC to reflect that.
Commissioners, how would that affect our being able to rent out our senior centers for nonprofit meetings?
I believe we're not subject to our own rules for that. Well, there are a lot of things that ought to be.
But I know Boy Scouts and Cubs, Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts, Patrick, don't you believe?
I'm trying to think of individual groups count as part of the nonprofit for the organization. You'd have to think this would do a lot when you get through. You might want to tell Ken.
You have different foundations.
Yeah, you got different foundations. You got a lot of nonprofit things that you just can't see. You got to meet in a commercial building.
They can't all afford to rent it.
Yeah.
Or use it. However, our Parks and Recs have a lot of facilities now.
Okay. Again, in the interest of time, if it's okay, I think if this were to pass,
sit down with Ken.
If this were to pass, it would go to the public hearing calendar. Is that correct, Counselor?
It would, but I think I would like to get a little guidance, just because I wanted to make sure I know where you're going. If you're truly going,
Don't you sit down with Ken and bring us back?
I'm not sure. We know where we're going. That's why I was going to say maybe we postpone this to the next agenda when we've had some time to.
Well, you know, in a nutshell, I guess the issue is this. This was a situation that went on for years, the Bridgepoint thing, and it got resolved with different documents and different agreements and things. And my main issue is not that they were religious or not religious. The issue was that, to the best of my knowledge, this is the only time that a nonprofit organization came and said, in your neighborhood, we'd like to build a building and start having meetings.
That's because a lot of neighborhoods have covenants that would present that.
Theirs had expired.
Theirs had expired.
Right.
I guess a lot of neighbors expire, 20 years? So.
A lot of problems.
I'm not saying
that you don't have a concern. I agree with Brian. Let's postpone it to another meeting just to talk about some more.
Yeah, so, and have time to talk.
Let's postpone it to
another meeting. Sit down with Ken and really go for it.
Let me offer up too, though, and I just want to say it. Now, UDC, the definition of church in our UDC, and nothing to do with the merits of church. It's just the UDC definition of church is a little awkward. I mean, it just is. It speaks to the purpose for which the building was engineered, and really leaves some gaping holes into what sorts of facilities are covered. It has nothing to do with whether we're tolerant or intolerant of church. I think it's a very tolerant place for churches. It's a matter of whether our UDC just needs some work to make it readable, and quite frankly, it makes sense.
That's why, let's bring back to the work session, and you and Mr. Boff talked about it.
Okay, if Commissioner Boff and maybe Tom Brown and I can get together, we'll bring you back a recommendation on some of
that. Is there a motion for postponement?
Yeah, I made a motion for postponement to the next work session and say, October 25th.
October 25th. Good motion, we have a second. Any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, like sign. There are none. That motion passes unanimously, and it's postponed.